storms and the rain to comfort and to guide me and to heal my pain. Lord, I need
Spirit now.
Lord, I need your
Spirit now.
Thank you, Jesus.
Into your presence at this moment with thanksgiving in our hearts, realizing, O God, that thou hast blessed us, watched over us, gave us another opportunity to come into your presence. As we come today, Heavenly Father, we come asking and seeking your forgiveness. We thank you for Jesus and his blood that was shed so that we might have the right to ask for forgiveness of our sins. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for all of the blessings of life. We thank you for life and health and strength and family and friends, O God. We thank you for the Holy Spirit that uplifts us, that leads and guides us as we go through these trials and troubles of this day and this time. For that, we truly say thank you. And we pray today, Heavenly Father, for those that are sick, those who have lost their loved ones to the pandemic. And we pray in particular for those in the Emmanuel Church family who have been in the hospital, and for a family that has suffered bereavement 3 times this week. For we know, Heavenly Father, that you said in your word that even though they may be in sorrow, that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for having the technology to reach out during this time when we can no longer gather in the house of the Lord. But even though we can't gather in the house of the Lord, we can gather in the Lord. So help our spirits and help our minds and our souls be with you here today as we attempt to say a word for you. Word that might serve as encouragement, a word that might serve as saving for somebody or deliverance. We just ask that you might speak so that they may hear. Bless us now as we continue on this journey, because one day at the end of this journey, we shall look to see you face to face. Where we will be tired. We will no longer be tired of the trials and troubles of this world. Where we'll be at peace and with rest with you. Bless us now and be with us this day. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The scripture I shall read for your hearing comes from Paul's letter to the church at Philippi. Philippians chapter number 3. And I will begin to read at verse number 12. Philippians chapter number 3. Verses 12 through 14. Not as though I have already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, that I may apprehend that for which I am also apprehended of Jesus Christ. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth for those things which are before, I press on toward the mark of the prize of the high calling of Christ Jesus. The word of God for the people of God. Amen. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Thank you again for joining in this live stream. Allow me to thank the Emmanuel Church family and others on Facebook for your generous support and giving. I read it the other day where it says, when you miss giving, you miss being blessed. So continue to give, and surely God has promised that he will give it back to you. Again, I said in the prayer, but let us remember the families in the church whose loved ones have been sick in the rest homes or in the hospitals, but also those who have suffered bereavement. And also, we always remind you, just call somebody and check up on them, see how they're doing. I'm sure that they would appreciate knowing that somebody cares about them. Thank you and God bless you. God, in Jesus' name, as I come to say a word for you, I ask, O God, that you would speak to me, for thy servant heareth. In Jesus' name, amen. Philippians chapter number 3, verses 13 and 14. Verse 14 in particular, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do. Forgetting those things which are behind, I press on toward the mark for the prize of the high calling in Jesus. I want to use as a message today, pressing on. We're living in a time when it seems like everything just about is at a standstill. And even I found out, or I believe, that there are many Christians who are at a standstill in their faith, in their trust, and in their continuing moving toward the calling of Christ in their life. Here in these verses, the Apostle Paul gives us three things. He gives us the past, the present, and the future. The past, which is gone, the present, which is now, and the hope for our future. But in particular for the now, he used the term pressing on. Paul was blessed. He was truly blessed with the amazing ability to look at everything through the spiritual realm. No matter what Paul encountered, what he was up against, and everything he did, and everywhere he went, regardless of who he was talking to, whether it was the saint or the sinner, Paul always used the physical perspective to take them to the spiritual realm. I have not apprehended, Paul said. Paul was saying, I'm not where I desired to be, nor where Christ has called me to be. I'm not at what I should be, but this one thing I do, I focus. I have my attention on forgetting those things which are behind and reaching for those things which are before. I'm pressing on. Here we have Paul dealing, as I said, with the past, the present, and the future. He's saying where I have been, that's the past. Where I am now, that's the present. And where I hope to end up, that is the future. What was, what is, and what will be? I don't know how difficult it was for Paul to be able to come to the point in his life where he could say, forgetting those things which are behind, I press on toward the high mark in the calling of Jesus. I don't know how Paul got there, but I know that even in my life and maybe in your life, there are some things in the past that in order to get by them, it takes much prayer, takes much forgiving. And if you're not careful, you better watch out, because trying to forget, folks will remind you, and Satan will remind you, and bring up your past. But looking past, looking at and getting past the past is what Paul was talking about. So often people live in the past. I don't like to be on the church, but quite often the church lives in the past. That's the way we've always done it. and sees no reason to change it. But if the past is holding you down, the past has you shackled, if the past is causing you to fall short of your blessings, don't miss out on the opportunity. Put those things behind you. Far too many are being hindered, being detained, being distracted, stuck, stalled, because of your past. Past mistakes, past habits, past behavior. But if anyone is going to press on, Paul is saying here, put the past behind you. It's water under the bridge. And one door is not going to open until you close the one behind you. Now, the word press is an adjective. It speaks of a problem or need or a situation that requires quick or immediate attention. Added to the words like urgent, and critical, and necessary. If we're going to face a time that we're faced with like never before, doing things that we never thought we would have to do, requiring us to do stuff in a different way, we cannot allow ourselves to be so focused on what's happening in the world and act like we don't serve a mighty God. It's not how we react to what's happening to us, it's how we react on what's going on around us. Pressing on. We need to learn to stay firm. Realize that God is still God. We need to exercise our faith. We need to have more strength and learn to trust God more. Scripture says we need to draw nigh to God, and He will draw nigh to us. In other words, if we get closer to God, God will get closer to us. God has been doing pretty good. He's been blessing us, going out and coming in, and He assigns angels over us, and His compassions fail not, and he does so much for us. So if we are going to be all that we can for Christ, we're going to have to learn how to press on. It's going to require persistence. The old folks used to say, don't take no prisoners. It'll take determination. It takes keeping your hand to the plow and not looking back. I know it's concerning to everybody. I don't care how you may be in Christ today. We're all affected by this shutdown. But let me tell you something. Don't get shut out because of the shutdown. Nothing has gone on and stopped with God. God is still blessing. God is still making ways out of no ways. God is still giving us strength to the weak, still feeding and clothing us. God is still showing His grace and His mercy. So if the God who we know He is, and Jesus, we know He is, then we need to decide today that we need to press on. Let us not get discouraged. Let us not sit on the sideline and become weary in well-doing. Let us be reminded of the words of Paul, the past is gone. The only time we have is the present. And the future is that which we are pressing for, that which we hope for, that which we believe is going to happen in the future. I don't believe that God is through. I believe that God still has some more blessings. I believe that God still has some more miracles. I believe that God has some more breakthroughs. I believe that God has a whole lot more favor that he wants to show. I want to encourage you, tell you that your tomorrow can be blessed more than your day. Just keep on pressing on. Press on. Press past your worries. He has his eye on the sparrow, and he watches over you. Press on any doubt, because when I woke this morning, I didn't have no doubt. Press on past your fears, because he's not given us the spirit of fear, but of a sound mind. Yes, keep pressing on. Keep praying. Paul said, man ought always pray. Keep on studying his word. Keep on pressing on. As the songwriter put it, I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still pressing, because I know I'm homeward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. I know it's some more days coming, but I believe there's some better days coming. I believe that we have not seen the best yet, but the only way that we'll get there is to put the past behind us. Press on. Keep pressing. Press till your prayer is answered. Press till your miracle is received. Press till your problem is solved. Pressed until you receive all the things that God has and has promised you. Keep pressing on. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you today for the words of Paul to realize that in such a time as this, that we shouldn't sit down, we shouldn't quit, we shouldn't worry, we shouldn't have any fear. We should be like Paul, that regardless of what's happening in the world, that we are going to continue to press on. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Real, real good. Amen. So